You know, there are other faiths, other religions in the world, they want to kill us because we are Christians. These are our enemies. You can call them Islamists or Muslims, fanatics. So, if you go to those countries and you profess your faith, okay. You know that not all the Muslims are the same, but there are fanatics groups. So, this is a long subject to develop. I'm not going to enter here right now. But then we have enemies. They can be the family. So we need to love them. It's not easy, eh? It's not easy. Okay, we need to love our neighbor. Victims are all over. Victims of discouragement. How many victims of discouragement are right now? And the pandemic doesn't help too much. It dips the sense of discouragement. If you were discouraged before the pandemic, this put it down more discouragement. So we need to help the others, not to have a personal conversation face to face, but there is a phone, there are other means of communication. We need to help others. The other point is related to Galatians, the readings of the Galatians. What St. Paul says to those who abandon or change the gospel that was transmitted to us in the tradition from the first Christians to us. So he is referring, especially St. Paul is referring to those who insist on adding obedience to Old Testament's laws to their requirements for salvation. So you need to not to eat these animals because they have their feet divided and things like that. Don't eat snakes or frogs and all those things. You know those laws. So, but somebody were saying, if you eat that, you cannot be saved. So Paul is talking about those guys. But we have those who have they have changed our teachings. So what did St. Paul say about them? They are accursed. You see, that's, they are condemned. He's not soft. They are condemned. I don't want to mention anybody, but they run out of those. And we need to be careful not to fall into those cafeteria Catholics. Oh, purgatory, maybe it doesn't exist anymore, it's something like that. Maybe hell doesn't exist anymore. This is an invention to scare us. Or many things like that. Or abortion maybe is allowed. Maybe it will come with all those things. Cafeteria Catholics. Those who pick and choose, you said that. Those who chooses what is convenient for them. And they put aside the rest of our beliefs. Do you understand what I mean? That's right. We cannot be cafeteria Christians. We have to accept the whole package. If we are Catholics, we accept all our beliefs. We don't take this and left aside the other one. Okay. Hopefully I made myself understood with this. So it's not a matter of, oh, this I don't like this belief. Mm-mm. So think of what St. Paul says today about those that divert our faith. Oops, I get along to that. Points. Do you understand, my brothers and sisters, the 3 points about the daughters, sons and daughters of Job? A little detail, I would say. The second one, we need to love our neighbor, especially those who don't like our enemies. And third, we cannot change our faith. Make tweaks to the faith. No? Okay.
As those called to see everyone as our neighbor, worthy of love, let us offer our prayers to the Lord.
That our Holy Mother Church may continue to receive the help of Christ in using her prophetic voice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That judges, juries, and law enforcement may be guided by God in balancing judgment with mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That victims of violence or racism may find healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this faith community may grow in holiness and a spirit of thanksgiving through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, may find peace in God's presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for who or what else would you like to pray?
For the Holy Souls in Purgatory, let us pray tomorrow.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a special intention, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those victims of coronavirus, they might find healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those affected by the virus and for the cause, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray all this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
May we be accepted by the Lord. Next to the blessed of Saints, they will be seated in your bow. Washing your foot with the endless and promise. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice at your hand, with the praise and glory of his name, and our good of all his church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries, which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for just as through your beloved Son, you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you form it anew, And so, it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. As therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, 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 Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them that they perform, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jerome, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Especially, Lord, remember our brother Jerry Ketchmark. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles, Blessed Francis Xavier Cyrus, and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and informed by divine teaching, we tend to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of our Lord and of
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for your reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. May the receiving of your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ, not do me to judgment and condemnation, but through your loving mercy, be for me protection in mind and body, and behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel.
I know, I saw that, and I...
Yeah, I'm not trying to spoil everything.